the great Andrea Boccelli performing his song in his music video, Grazia Plena, from the new movie Fatima. Andrea Boccelli's a Catholic singing this great song, Grazia Plena, Full of Grace. We know it's part of the Hail Mary. This is a great film that just recently came out. Very professionally done, great acting, telling the story about Fatima and the faith of these little children that brought hope to a country and that was dealing with World War I, and obviously through Mary. I keep the music going just because it's beautiful, but also it made me think of today's essay for our How the Church Changed the World. It's called The Church Mater Dramatist. It tells a story about a Spanish man from the 1600s who wrote over 200 shows, plays, and not unlike some of the other we heard at the beginning of our series, those town shows that the churches would put on. That was the kind of the root of drama as we know it to this day, and how Shakespeare would build on that because that's what he was exposed to back in the 1500s in England. Well, now the 1600s, we see this man developing these great dramas, and he would eventually become a priest. His name was Pedro Calderon de la Barca, and they consider him the greatest dramatist in the golden age of Spanish literature. So I'm going to pause here before that moves on. And so really remarkable, again, to see the ways that the church helped to move forward this idea of not just, we've talked about science and the different ways that the church contributed to education and medicine, but again, going back to the idea of even our cultural dramas and this use of the drama to not only entertain, but to inspire. And so he became a priest, and so obviously he did quite a few sacramentally focused or kind of the incarnational and redemptive plays that he wrote over the years. And so we could be kind of ready to dismiss him and say, well, that's what a priest would do. But we don't forget, in the midst of that same 1600 year window, the greatest lyric poet in the golden age of Spain was Juan de la Cruz. We know him as St. John of the Cross, the mystic poet who was a priest. The greatest psychologist of the inner life, who we talked about just yesterday, his friend, that cloister nun, St. Teresa of Avila. His greatest professor that Calderon had was also a priest, Lope de Vega, and they say he was rather mischievous. And then, of course, we already talked about that great titan of Spanish literature, Cervantes, who loved this to boast that he was in the Battle of Lepanto and was a prisoner of war for many years. So we see this, and again, we in our Catholic faith, we see not just the drama portrayed in these stories that these people would write, but also in the very word of God, the Gospels. The Gospel story, the story of salvation, is a true drama. And everywhere we go, we see these amazing stories of Peter and Saul and their conversions, and the Old Testament, the Abrahams and the Moses, these dramatic moments that made for TV because of the twists and the turns and all the great different ways that they engage us in the story and their real life. I love watching movies based on real life because you get to learn, but the drama of life is there. And there's no greater drama than the redemption of the world, starting with creation, the fall, and then that great high point in all of history, the Word made flesh in Jesus Christ redeems us, and then this ongoing effort of the church to live it out, the second coming, bringing that creation to its completion in our Lord Jesus Christ. So that's the drama of our faith, and that's the drama that these stories touch on. So continuing to find ways that we can support, again, movies like Fatima, and seeing more and more people, as we talked about with those great, the Catholic directors of movies, John Ford and I'm completely blanking on the other one, but in the movies that they wrote, to really get our Catholics to rise up to be involved as musicians, as and be involved in art, be involved in theater, be involved in Hollywood, in cinema, and use those mediums to tell the powerful stories. We have the greatest drama, redemption of man. There's no greater story than the redemption of man, the Paschal mystery, and how our God brings resurrection from the cross and death. It is the greatest drama. And so to bring that into real stories and real life, and to engage people to entertain them, but yet inspire them and help them see. We need our Catholic and our Christian communities to think about those vocations and to find more of a place to express these things that can have such a powerful impact on our world, because we know they are right now, and they're not doing it in a really inspiring way. And that's another thing that adds to the despair and the desperation we see in our culture. So we thank God for people like our main focus today, Pedro Calderon de la Barca, and all those of the Spanish efforts that we mentioned. And we pray that the church can continue to play that role in changing the world through the great gift of drama and cinema and music. Check out Grazia Plena. Go see Fatima. I highly recommend it. God bless. Thanks for joining. Take care.